I'm Peter Brown from Tiny and Sons Glass. Tiny and Sons Glass was established in 1978 with my father and brother and I. We're at 575 Washington Street in Pembroke. We're certified and qualified to do all your windshield replacement and repair. Tiny and Sons Glass is a community-based business. We have 12 mobile vans that come to you. If the weather's bad, you can come here to the shop. We have a nice waiting area, TV, Wi-Fi, kid-friendly, pet-friendly. We also can move about 15, 20 cars a day through the shop. Perfect for you when the weather's bad. So come on down to Tiny and Sons Glass if you need your windshield replaced or repaired. Tiny and Sons Glass, 1-888-64-TINIES. Just call. Thank you.
I'm Arthur Boyle of Performance Appraisal Services. We're residential real estate appraisers with a company founded in 1994 by Mike Gianelli and I in the basement of my house in Malden. We've since grown to have offices in Malden and Pembroke. We serve the Eastern Mass counties, including Cape Cod. A good client for us is an attorney or a private landowner or a private property owner who's going through a probate process or a divorce division of property. Call us at 781-293-6900. Ask for Arthur Boyle or Amanda Boyle Grazioso. Our first name is Performance.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Board of Selectmen's meeting of February 27th. And we'll begin with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through a live video and audio broadcast on Comcast Government Access Channel 15 and is being recorded for broadcast at future dates. Comments made in open session will be recorded. Just a note of explanation, we're starting a little earlier tonight at 6:30. A couple of reasons for that is, one, the Planning Board is holding public hearings, and Mr. Fawn will be meeting with advisory at 7:30 to go over the budget for next year. So at 6:30, we have a scheduled appointment with the First Church, and Gail Simmons with us. Would you like to come up front, please? Thank you. We have the information in front of us about the days that you want, and the police will be hired and so forth. Did you have any issues that you wanted to bring to our attention?
This, just for your information, is the same company that saved us last year and has come back now in full force. This is the only show he's doing that weekend. He was wonderful to deal with. A very family-based outfit, Larry Cushing's. He's out of the North Shore. And I was very pleased, and I hope it will bring us more country fair kind of like Brett than, you know, it's evolved over the years. So that's what we're looking for. He's only going to do 3 days. He does it all on his own. You know, he doesn't have a big company with him, so it takes him that long to set up properly. They have to be inspected before they can run, so he felt the extra day, and I thought it was good for us. It took us off Memorial Day a little bit, so that he'll be coming in right after that, but he will not be setting up the day after. He'll just be coming in that day. So.
Okay. And I see that you'll require space for our trailers behind the community center.
Just a few, and not too many. It will be. Right. It's the equipment he's not using, or there's some equipment that hauls the rides in.
Mm-hmm.
Not as much as before, but he just has a lot of.
That's a standard requirement, right. I remember. And police and EMT details will be hired for the hours. Last year we have a walkthrough by Scott Globin scheduled the pre-fair walkthrough. And I know the selectmen participate in that, so. We will have to arrange that as well.
Okay, as soon as it gets closer, then we'll be able to tell when he will be in town, he'll meet with Scott. That's kind of what we did the last time, and then we'll let you know. It'll be somewhere on that Tuesday, but by probably not first thing in the morning, because he comes from Wilmington if he does it, or he's coming the other way, so I don't know, but that, it'll be that Tuesday prior to. He's, and he'll probably will be in contact with Scott before as well. He was pretty good with that last year. He wants to be sure to get it correct.
And you're also looking to close Curve Street as usual.
That's right.
Another requirement as well.
Yeah.
Does the board have any questions?
I think that the, I think the last time too, I think they got a hold of the veterans agent.
Right. And I think we'll contact him as well.
Yeah, whatever, so that,
like to see him
so that they can
well.
Make sure they're involved in that walkthrough and all that.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, John Kern from the American Legion.
Yeah.
They were notified about this, of course.
Yeah.
Right. We didn't have any trouble last time.
No,
at
that's
all.
Fine.
And you know, we've gotten to a point. This, Larry Cushions has done other towns like Andover, and a few more on the North Shore, that he works right on their town green as well.
Yeah.
And he comes from a background. His father, one grandfather did town stuff, and the other one did athletic stuff, so he's always worked with that kind of facility, and
yeah.
It's very cautious about all those kinds of things.
Very good.
Good.
I was
awesome.
Really pleased with our time last year, and I'll be very glad to spend more time with him this year. So.
Good.
Are there any other questions from the board?
I'd just like to say that if the last handful of years, Arthur and I have been designated to do the pre and post walkthroughs, and I myself would volunteer for that.
That's what I think. Dan and I are familiar with the process, and we work well together. So.
Very good. I know that's been an ongoing thing. So.
Right.
So we will do that. If there are any other questions or comments, I'll look for a motion, please.
A motion to approve, Mr. Chairman. As written, at the First Church of Pembroke, their annual Old Home Days Fair in the parking lot of the grounds of the Town Memorial Green, surrounded by the church from Thursday, June 1st through Saturday, June 3rd, to close Curve Street starting on May 30th, conditionally upon the inspection and approval of the Board of Health, and details by the police chief and the fire chief, and to grant permission for the use of the community center rear parking area during this time for 10 trailers for the storage of Cushing amusement equipment.
Motion by Bill. Is there a second? Second by Arthur. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none. It's unanimous.
Thank you very much.
Coming in, Gail.
I hope I won't have to come back quickly.
We have a public hearing at 6:45, so we're a little early, so I'd like to ask the board to go to the action items, and we have an agenda item to open the special within the annual warrant for the town meeting to be held on May 9th. Have a discussion or a motion on that, please.
Move to open the special town meeting warrant within the annual town meeting and close both on 3/3/17, March 3rd.
At 4:30.
Motion by Arthur. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Matthew. Any questions? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none. That's unanimous. We could skip down to the town's vote response to the River Marsh LLC application for the 40B on 274 Water Street.
One thing I'd just like to say about this this letter that Ed and Sabrina did here to Mr. Busby, who was in charge of the mass housing permits there, was I don't think that there was anything left out. It seems everything that I could possibly ever think of is in here, in the letter.
Well,
I think it was very
Mr.
well
Chairman,
done.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to defer all the credit to Sabrina. This is her master's thesis. She's going to bypass undergraduate school and go straight to an MBA program. This is an excellent job.
Excellent job.
Really,
yes. Very nice job.
Well, this has been a good opportunity for the selectmen to meet with folks from a neighborhood for a specific purpose, and I think we can be very proud of the work that we've done thus far. We certainly owe Sabrina a debt of gratitude for the work that she's done, but I think it shows that the system can work for the neighborhoods if everybody pulls in the same direction.
Hopefully.
Well, it certainly is, you know, if there's ever been 100% of a neighborhood in one direction or another, this is it.
Yeah.
Well, I think the board can certainly agree to the previous comments about the job that was done in putting this together. We have 8 exhibits that go with it as well, and we will be overnighting that to Mass Housing, and there was a deadline on that, and we will meet that deadline with no issue. So it's a job well done by everybody, and particularly Sabrina, who put all this together.
And I think there's a walkthrough scheduled March 8th. Is that right, Sabrina?
He's still confirming, but he sent a note today that he's shooting for March 8th.
March 8th,
it's a secondary site for that location. And as soon as I hear it, we'll send out a note.
Now, we will be signing this.
Yep, absolutely. That'll be okay. Here.
So the Board of Selectmen will all sign this document before it gets sent into Mass Housing. So,
this March 1st deadline, is that for the postmark? Because the letter certainly won't reach them by March 1st.
We're FedExing it. We have a pickup at 9 a.m. tomorrow. It's going to be in hand by the end of the day.
Great.
So it'll be a day early, just to make sure.
Okay. Do we need a vote on this at all? I don't think so. Ed?
Yeah.
We can have it as formality.
Okay.
But,
I'll entertain a motion then.
I would move that we sign the letter as written.
Second.
Motion by Arthur and second by Bill. Any comments? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. A job very well done. I'd like to move down again to an action item. The item before me right now is a resignation letter from David McPhillips, who is the town's veterans agent, and it will be effective on March 31st of this year.
I move to accept the resignation of David McPhillips from the appointed position of veterans agent with regret, and it will be effective March 31st, 2017.
Second.
Motion by Bill and a second by Arthur. Any comments or questions?
Well, they say nobody's irreplaceable, but we're about to find out.
Yeah.
He's done a great job over the years.
Such a nice guy, and has done a great job, yes. I agree with that 100%.
Yeah, I can certainly state my opinion that Dave McPhillips has just stepped into that veterans agent job and has done a superlative job for the veterans and for the town of Pembroke. And I would agree that we're all going to miss him, but it'll be our job to try to find someone to fill that slot.
I concur. Dave's done a terrific job. He's been a great servant of the veterans in town. He's held that position admirably. And I expect that Mary Whitman will be up to the task to train someone new. She's been a key person in that office with her, and but fortunately Dave will be around town, and hopefully we can mine him for information for ourselves and for his successor.
Well, that's a good point about Dave's assistant. Mary has been in that job for a long time, certainly knows it well. So we're fortunate in that regard. So we have a motion and a second. Are there any other issues or questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous.
Mr. Chairman, I would move that we allow the town administrator to begin to advertise for the position so that we lose as little time as possible.
Second.
That's a good suggestion. Motion by Arthur to advertise for a someone to fill that job, and second by Dan. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. Another quick issue we have before us is a resignation on the Historic District Commission of Mr. James Bennett, who has moved out of town and will be unable to fill that position. We have a letter from the Historic Commission to that effect. Do I have a motion, please?
Move to accept the resignation of James Bennett.
Motion by Arthur. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Matthew. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous.
Question.
Yes, Dan.
I do get them mixed up sometimes. So the Historic District Commission, is that the elected office? That's the appointed. Thank you.
Okay. We are now at time for public hearing. We have a poll hearing to hear a joint position of National Grid and Verizon to replace a pole on Spring Street. And I believe we have somebody here from National Grid. Would you like to come up front, please? And give us your name.
Well, my name is Simon Young, engineer based in Brockton. And we are proposing to a pole in place of a tree that is currently supporting the current infrastructure in the street. Me and another engineer already met with the customer that the pole is going to be dealing with in front of, because the customer is taking down the trees and all that for gardening reasonings. And now we stake the pole at the location where the customer is satisfied. And that was currently now would support the infrastructure that the tree is going to be removed from.
Good. That's at 117 Spring?
Yes.
Yeah. Good. Are there any questions from the board to the gentleman? Hearing none, I would entertain a motion. First, let me just say that I would normally ask if there's anyone here that wants to speak, because there wasn't a butters list that was notified. But I don't find anyone here, so we can go ahead with our motion and our vote.
Move to grant approval of National Grid on their petition to install a new subpole 21-84 across the street from pole 21 to support the guide wire preventing the pole from leaning and removing existing support guide wire attached to the tree in accordance with work order and plan number 226-10128.
Motion by Bill. Is there a second? Second by Arthur. Any questions from the board? Hearing none, all those in favor of that motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none. It's a unanimous vote. Thank you for coming in. And when do you anticipate doing this?
Once I tell the clerk, our National Grid clerk, they will go straight to the scheduler, and then they'll probably do the dig save and the pre-scheduling, pre-construction type of checks and stuff.
Very good. Well,
he's done a great job in town so far, replacing a lot of poles in town.
Yeah, from my schedule, it seems like they're trying to pick up on some work.
Yeah.
And it seems like the winter is pretty slow this year, so they're trying to pick up on stuff, upgrading and all that.
Good job.
Very good. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
We have a request for a special one-day liquor license. Back Hall Bench for ALS, and they're located in Corporate Park. This is an event where they will be serving alcohol, and we have all of the information before us. This is a fundraiser for ALS, and are there any questions from the board on this request? Hearing none, can I have a motion, please?
Move to approve the application of Susan Cardacci. We're going to kill that one.
Cardacci.
Cardacci from the Back Hall Bench for ALS 1 for special liquor license under the Mass General Laws 138, Section 14, to serve beer and wine on Saturday, March 25th, 2017, from 5 to 8 o'clock at 300 Oak Street, unit number 200.
It's a motion by Bill. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Matthew. Any questions from the board? Hearing none, all those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. We have a request from the town's treasurer, Kathleen McCarthy, for the board to accept a property at 21 South Boundary Road as a tax possession property. And we have some information before us concerning that issue. Do I have any questions or comments, or can I have a motion, please?
Motion to accept the treasurer's recommendation.
Second.
Motion by Arthur to accept the recommendation, second by Bill. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. Now we have some sets of minutes to approve, three separate sets. I'll take them one at a time, and the first one is for the minutes of the Selectmen's meeting of February 6th. So I have a motion.
Move the minutes of February 6th is written.
Second.
Motion by Arthur and second by Bill. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. We also have a set of minutes from the Selectmen's meeting of February 11th. I have a motion on those minutes.
Mr. Chairman, I vote to accept as written.
Second.
Motion by Bill and a second by Arthur. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Present, not voting.
Dan is present and not voting, so four in favor. The third set of minutes is for the Selectmen's meeting of February 15th. Do I have a motion?
Move to approve the minutes of February 15th, 2017 as written.
Second.
Motion by Arthur and a second by Bill. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Hearing none. That's unanimous. under old business, excuse me. On August 9th, 2016, Governor Baker signed an act to modernize municipal finance and government. And the Board of Selectmen may designate any one of its members for the purpose of approving bills or payrolls under this section, provided that the member shall make available to the board at its next meeting a record of such actions. On February 14th, I personally reviewed and signed 10 account payable warrants totaling $577,763.47, and one payroll warrant totaling $210,529.55, which were prepared by the town accountant. And this authorizes the itemized expenditures for payment, signed Lewis W. Stone. Also, under the same act, on February 22nd, I also signed and personally reviewed, February 22nd, seven account payable warrants totaling $672,073.88, and two payroll warrants totaling $1,215,383.53, which were prepared by the town accountant and who authorized the itemized expenditures for payment, signed Lewis W. Stone. Any questions? We'll move on to the town administrator's report.
Mr. Chairman, a couple of things while we were on the subject of 40Bs earlier. I just wanted to let the board know that PAC TV produced another Pembroke Today Show in which Julie Thompson and myself discussed the process of 40Bs, and then in particular the River Marsh LLC project. So we explain to the public how the system works, what options the town has and its residents, and you know, exactly what the Board of Selectmen is doing on behalf of the residents of Pembroke and especially the area of Water Street Extension. And also tonight I'll be presenting the FY18 budget for advisory, and I believe the board's received a copy of the full budget in addition to my budget message. Excluding water and sewer, the budget will be approximately $62 million for FY18. We are pretty much exhausting, and as I mentioned in my message, pretty much all local receipts, we've maxed them out. Usually in the past, Mr. Buckley, our town accountant, has lowballed the revenue so that we would generate more free cash or surplus revenue at the end of the year in order to balance this budget without having any extra people or any extra programs. We had to increase the levy, tax levy, as according to about 2.5. We received minimal increases in state aid, and so we increased local receipts as much as we could based on FY16 actuals. So that being said, you know, I'll be presenting a balanced budget, but there'll be some projects and some recommendations by some of the department heads that, you know, will still left to be discussed, you know, with advisory, with the board, and with these departments. It's not pretty, but it's what it is in most communities right now.
So basically, we have a balanced budget, but we are using all of our resources in order to balance that budget.
Yeah, based on FY16 actuals. We didn't do any further projections than that. We certainly didn't want to extend ourselves more than we fiscally responsibly should be able to do. So that's where we are as of February 27th. And we got all of March and April to tweak any of these things. And I'm sure those will be discussions that Mr. Buckley and I and department heads will have with the advisory committee between now and the Board of Selectmen between now and town meeting.
Okay. Any questions for Ed? Hearing none, we will move on to ask the selectmen. Are there any issues to be discussed here?
No ice on the pond.
No ice on the pond.
There's no ice on the pond.
Very good.
Lou, I'll take it up under this if you don't mind. I recently attended the latest Old Colony Planning Council meeting, as I'm the town's delegate to that. And we had a discussion about their district local technical assistance program that the Pembroke Planning Board has applied for. Are you involved with that, with them, Ed, in conjunction with them?
I mean, I did originally, but then when Matthew Hines, you know, came aboard, you know, we informed the Old Colony Planning Council people that he would be the contact person. But I remember the executive director reached out to me last summer when that program was first announced.
Okay, so it's a program run through our Regional Planning Council that assists towns for various reasons, and I believe the focus of the planning board is economic development in Pembroke. So I look forward to them taking the lead in this program with their thoughts, but I'll also look forward to helping them and assisting them as both a selectman and a member of the Old Colony Planning Council. So I just wanted to bring that to your attention. And also something that's coming up that the Board of Selectmen will need to consider and vote on at some point. the town of Pembroke is currently a member of two metropolitan planning organizations. The Old Colony Planning Council is a regional planning council, but the metropolitan planning organization is a facet of that planning council, which helps towns in their region get roadway work done and helps them work through the state. Well, the town of Pembroke is also on the on the Greater Boston Area MPO. So we're involved with two different planning councils, and the federal government just came down with a decision that said you can only have one planning organization. So the town of Pembroke will need to choose who we go with for our roadway work. And part of the consideration that we need to think of is to get on the TIPS program, the state TIPS program. The projects that we have in hand now are through the Old Colony Planning Council. So if this board, and we'll study it further, but the takeaway here is if we choose to go with the Boston region, we will need, I believe we need to reassign out of that TIPS program into a new one, which means we'll start all over again. So I don't think we want to do that, but we'll have to consider it closely. The other thing to consider when we do, we'll get the information to you through Ed so that we can take a vote on it. The other thing to consider is, do we want to be part of a local regional planning council with towns like Pembroke, Kingston, Hanover, the Bridgewaters, with one city, Brockton, or do we want to be part of the Greater Boston Area planning council? Boston, Peabody, you have it. All the cities in and around Boston, and fight with them for state dollars in the roadways. So
this is OCPC versus MAPC.
Exactly right.
Well, that's an easy decision.
I think so too, but let's get the information in front of us and we'll make an informed decision shortly.
Yeah, I mean, I get the sense that I know what your recommendation is going to be.
I'm kind of leaning one way. It's pretty obvious with that, but we'll get the information in front of you first.
I think that's in the best interest of the town.
Yeah. Okay, so perhaps by next meeting we'll get that information to you so you can make an informed decision.
Very good. Well, these are all very important issues, and we're fortunate that we have Dan on top of this, and we're looking forward to seeing the information that he brings to us. And we will do definitely what is going to be more beneficial for Pembroke. So thank you, Dan.
Mr. Chairman, I got one more thing for your report. I did have Sabrina give you folks a solid waste report on the trash program here in town and recycling program. And you'll see some narratives there if you have any questions regarding that. But obviously the percent recycling percentage continues to climb. The amount of tonnage that we are disposing of, either through New Bedford Waste or through Waste Management in Avon for our recyclables, continues to go down. And the activity at the recycling center continues to go up. And so, you know, I'm thinking that as part of the FY18 budget, at very little additional cost to the solid waste budget, and certainly no increase to the fees, that we are looking at increasing the number of hours at the recycling center on Saturday from 6 to 9. But based on what we have in our budget and based on the reduced cost of disposing of trash and recycling, I believe that the solid waste budget information won't be increased by a nickel, but we'll be able to increase the number of hours at the recycling center because it's being used more than ever. And you look at the data that shows the number of cars that visit the center, the number of people that use the center on a weekly basis.
Well, I think it's very important to note that the people that work at the recycling center are there to serve the residents of Pembroke. And if we can't continue to do that on 6 hours on Saturday and we have to expand those hours, That's what our job is, but it's also good to hear that other issues in the solid waste budget are going to help us. There won't be any increased cost.
That's correct.
So I don't think you can do any better than that. Better service and no increased cost. Doesn't happen very often.
I just got one thing while you're talking about the selectmen there. I attended Thursday night the North River Commission meeting in Norwell, and there still has been no application from River Marsh LLC for the North River Commission to look at and approve. So there's still no application that's been submitted there. So they really can't make a decision about anything until they get an application with plans. And I explained to the commission that the current plans that are there are from 2002 or whatever. So we did have some discussion about it. So their eyes and ears are open for, you know, whatever may come up in the near future.
Are they likely to take a public position on the opposition of the development in that area?
Well, I think that would definitely be considered a public position, but, you know, there has to be a proper plan proposed, and whether that would be good for that area down there. And personally, myself, I don't think it would be, but that would be a decision amongst all the different towns being involved in it, which is not a good thing for the North River. So.
Okay. New business. Does anyone have any new business they'd like to bring up? Hearing none, I will go on to our schedule of upcoming issues. On March 13th at 7 o'clock, the surplus property auction results will be available for a parcel of property on Bartlett Street. On March 20th at 7:30 p.m., we will have a public hearing for a street acceptance, Equestrian Way and Pheasant Lane. On March 27th at 7 p.m., Jennifer Mathias, the Hill Bog Project Update. That is on Valley Street. Tonight at 7:30, there will be a Planning Board public hearing looking for a public comment on whether to amend the Town of Pembroke zoning bylaws entitled Center Protection District in order to eliminate the option of mixed-use development as a use allowed by special permit. And the next regularly scheduled meeting of the Board of Selectmen is on March 3rd at 7 p.m.
That's almost the same day, March 6th.
March 6th, okay, thank you. Correct that. March 6th, I'll be there. Thank you. Now, do we have a need for executive session, Mr. Thorne?
Yes, sir.
Could I have a motion on that, please?
Mr. Chairman, move that we go into executive session to discuss strategy with respect to collective bargaining and litigation. If an open meeting may have a detrimental effect on the bargaining or litigation position of the public body, and the chair so declares. The clerical, DBW, police, and fire unions.
And the chair does declare. Motion by Bill. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, and we'll take a voice vote. Dan?
Yes.
Matthew?
Yes.
Bill?
Yes.
Arthur?
Yes.
And I vote yes.
The chairman, we have some gentlemen here that may want to address the board. Okay. 7:30.
Oh, okay.
Is that here or next door?
Okay. Be next door.
This is informative. Thank you for letting us know.
Well, thank you very much for coming tonight. The planning board hearing is a is
we'll
an important hearing.
We'll be over there
hearing.
Later.
Okay. And we will be joining you.
Look forward to that.
Save us a chair. Okay, so we will be going into executive session, and I don't believe there'll be a need to have a vote at the end of that, Mr. Bond.
No.
So we will adjourn our meeting at the end of executive session, and we will see you all next week on March 6th at 7 p.m. Thank you for watching, and have a good evening.